Hi everyone, feel warmly welcome to Usitility. Today we are on the way to see how to play Magic Jigsaw Puzzles on your PC. As you can see, you can watch it on screen. It takes almost no time to simply download and install Magic Jigsaw Puzzles so that we can play the game on the Windows PC using our keyboard, mouse and big screen. So it's time to have fun, let's go buddies. Before anything else folks, to start we have to launch our favorite web browser. We selected the one we use by default. Let's continue, going to the next URL I'm highlighting in green color. Now, you can see on the screen of the PC. There is no need to type anything, because I provided a clickable link in the description of this video and the first pinned comment. We arrived here on our own website of Usitility, in which we have our in-depth information on the way to download and install Magic Jigsaw Puzzles on computer. We browse down a tad and simply click on the Download Game on PC button. After clicking on the link, we reach the website of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we are going to use to play Magic Jigsaw Puzzles on the PC. It is now obvious that we have some pros of preferring using the emulator. Then, we will start downloading the Magic Jigsaw Puzzles by clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that you can visualize here in green. We then click on it. Of course, the download action takes no time at all. Here it is, here is located the download. It's a file to execute. The following step is to run the installer, okay, then we need to click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to make modifications to the device. We clicked yes. I reduced the browser to start to see the installer better. The installation software is very easy to use. It is made up of two possibilities, install, and setup path. I am going to clarify what setup path truly does. We purely simply click on it. Therefore we see that got here the path in which the emulator can be installed. If we desire to vary this folder we are required to click on this, browse, button, and now we decide on another folder and install the emulator precisely where we desire. I am going to set it by default. I simply click on back. And therefore I click on install. Great. The installation commences and it will commence with the download of these MB that happens to be shown on that screen. After you download it, it might possibly be more or less MB. The data transfer speed might go at a higher speed or slower, subject to your web access and depending on the speed of the emulator hosting servers. Right now they're progressing very fast. The download has been successful, and straight away it proceeds with the setup phase. The installation is going to take a little bit more or less time primarily based on the power of your computer. The more robust it actually is, the faster the installation time and or vice versa. If we join the download and setup stage it may take a very long time, so be patient. It has already completely finished on my side. At this point, the emulator has been started automatically. As you will notice, down here, we have a progress bar that will fill up and when it gets to the finish, the emulator can be started for the very first time. The reality is the emulator has already been started, here it is for the very first time. Before we continue on, as you can see, it created two app icons here on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon will be only one we are considering. When we need to start Magic Jigsaw Puzzles on our laptop or computer, we double-click on this specific icon and consequently start the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance app icon is not related to multiplayer or even anything like that. The reality is, it's an software icon that we may most likely never start using. We should do the next phase, which is a must-have, and that is to entry the Google Play Store. As you will notice the Google Play is launched. At this point we have to log on. At present when we're here, we must definitely do the following step that is definitely absolutely mandatory. Therefore we simply click on, sign in. At this point it says, checking info. It might sometimes get stopped at, checking info, and it doesn't advance. In that case, you can attempt to log in after a number of hours and it will most certainly be solved. At this point we are going to provide our username and password. The email has to be a Gmail email address as well as its associated password. For instance, you may use the exact same email you're using right now in your own YouTube account. Therefore, I am going to type in my information and I'll return when I have done it. That's all, data typed. This is Google welcoming us and supplying us the terms of service. We should consent to them all simply by hitting, I agree. After that, it offers us to back up to the Google Cloud. You can keep it checked and it'll build a backup of your files on this device to Google Drive. I will not check it, you can utilize that option if you want. We simply click on accept. The Google Play Store is launched without need to open it manually and automatically. To set up the game, we have to browse the emulator desktop for Android by double-clicking on that icon designated green-colored. Currently that we are on the desktop of that emulator, we notice that we have here the install application option. We click or double-click on that button. At this point we have the Android game. So let's just click here on the install option that I am just showing now in green color. This will start the software setup. At this moment it would install the game app. It normally takes a bit of time or it could possibly be extremely fast. That all is subject to on our connection to the web. It's actually ended installing. Back to the emulator desktop by clicking on this specific button I'm highlighting in green, to be able to start Magic Jigsaw Puzzles for the very first time. Shall we click on this My Games option just above? I am already on the emulator desktop, and so we are preparing to click on this brand new Magic Jigsaw Puzzles software icon which was generated. That game is started for the first time. So there we have it, I'm able to press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to comment on the sound level of the emulator. This is here. We have the icon of higher volume as well as the icon of lower volume. This manner we don't rely on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound of your emulator. As well as to enjoy the experience to the greatest, we can activate the big screen, for which we have two choices. That is the very first one, we click on that icon that I am showing in green color. Then the screen is maximized, experiencing one border on top, one at the right and the last one at the bottom. Supposing that we want to play the game using all the screen, we select this game icon. And therefore we would presently be enjoying the Android game in full screen mode. To quit the complete screen functionality, click the F11 key. And we might currently be in standard screen mode. From now, I am going to explain you the keyboard mapping and that is extremely enjoyable. That step we may be capable to utilize the game app far more easily. The first point is to click on this application icon. It's now time to complete the necessary controls. I am going to keep the standard settings, though if you wish to modify that, you may well do this without any problem. Clearly, the emulator is completely in our own language. From time to time it occurs that the emulator is launched in the improper language, for instance, in Mandarin. So to set it in the appropriate language we click here to the cogwheel. So here throughout other controls, we click on the language drop-down. We can also select the language we wish, German, Japanese, etc. When the language is decided, we are going to save, the emulator would reboot, along with the video game, next time we run it, will also be in the chosen language. At this time, there is another thing that we must take into consideration, and it is that we will receive a message from Google Mail reporting that a different machine has been linked to our own Google account. It will definitely check with us if we are the individuals who have connected that device. That's right, we shouldn't get worried, since the emulator is simulating an Android tablet or smartphone. And then to see which tablet or smartphone is being emulated, we come back here, to the cogwheel and we simply click on it. So we go here to the model selection. And here we observe that the emulator is emulating a Samsung mobile phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it folks, so much for our tutorial. I sincerely hope you liked it, particularly that everyone thought it was interesting. In that case, offer it a great thumb up, subscribe, and if you have feedback, concerns or suggestions, put them in the comment box down below. You may also comment things on my Twitch channel, I do live streams ever so often, you get it listed below in the video description and in the initial pinned comment. Mouse click on any of those online videos that happens to be showing up on the computer screen and see you in the upcoming video game videos. Bye.